Hi everybody. This is Miss B Finance 101. I am so excited. I am in Alabama. I'm feeling good. But I just wanted to share this video. The title is Don't Wave Your Future. The reason why I'm doing this video is because I had a very interesting time yesterday, and I was just sitting with a friend of mine. And you know, she was like, I can't save any money. Like most of us, we feel like we don't have money. And we were talking, I told her, okay, let's go through your budget and everything, like I always do. And she was, when it reached to one point of the talk, I was like, okay, it really looked like most of your money are gone, but I wanted to see into your personal expenditure. Let's see how much you send money on. Okay, we realize, oh my God, she was sending almost average of $500 a month home. And you know, we in diaspora, we are so fortunate enough to have family back at home depending on us, and we are able to help. But one thing that I was telling her is, please let us not wave all our money home unless it's purposefully. So how can we ourselves learn to deal with the problems at home? How can we handle them without compromising our future? Because at the end of the day, nobody's in charge of our future but ourselves. So the reason why I'm doing this is not to stop anybody or to criticize anybody from sending money home. By all means, those people need your help. So we need to send money home. But some of the tips that I'm going to say is, you know, and we can discuss this. It's not me, my thing. I want to hear from you guys. What are you guys doing? What are some of the tips you're doing to do with some of the situation at home so that you're not waving all your funds, you're not feeling like you're struggling in diaspora and everybody else is advancing at home? What are some of the tips? So me to me, tip number one is understand the nature of the request. Okay, before you send that money, and you know, technology is so nice, we nowadays we just wave it. It's an app, we wave, hello, wave. Technology is so nice, but it's also so evil. Because when you used to go to store, if somebody asked you for $50, man, by the time you go to get into your car to go to Walmart, you'll have thought why. But before you send that wave, please ask yourself, is this really a need or a want? Okay, another thing you need to ask yourself is, can they live without this thing? Is it an emergency? Also, you also need to ask yourself, do they have any other option out there? Am I the only option that if I don't send this money, these people will absolutely not have anything? So that is the number one thing, is understand the nature of the request. Okay, the second thing you need to do is look at the future value of that money. And one of the things that I've learned is, let's say for example, you send $100. $100, if you were sending it, putting it into account in Kenya, worst case scenario, you get a simple account with 8% interest rate. That $100, which is 10,000 Kenya shillings, will give you 9,000 more by the end of the year, compounding at 8%, in simple interest of 8%. So you have to understand, you have to really, really understand the value of the future money. If the $50 you're sending today, before you send it, look at it like, is this thing really worth $250 in 20 years from now? You know, that is what it's going to be worth. So before you send that $50, no, you are taking $250 from your future account. So you really need to look at the future value of that money. Before you send $100, no, it might be 10,000 now, Kenya shillings, but at the end of the year, that's 19,000 Kenya shillings. Is that thing they're really requesting you for credit card really worth 19,000 at the end of the year? Look at the future value of that money you're about to send. Another thing you need to look is, stay within a budget. You gotta put your family on a budget. Oh my God. See, your mommy at a call, your mom will be, oh, please, naenda kwa matanga ya so and so. No, keep mom on a budget. I'm sorry, but you gotta keep them in a budget. especially for our single ones. Oh my God, there's so much because they don't see you guys as having obligation, unfortunately. That's why you guys take the backload of everything. I like it. If my sister say single, I'm like, well, before a request come in, I'm always like, hey, mtoto. So you gotta stick to a budget with home, you know, you gotta keep within a budget. Okay, keep within a, if it is 300, it's 300. Tell them, hey, my uncle, she does a nani na nani, mini kona sotatu, so mjipangi. If you guys are a couple of you guys, like in my family, we are six of us or many of us, we pick one family, one person. That person is in charge of all the requests. I like it like that. Let me tell you, because of that, I don't even have a Wave app in my phone. I'm serious. I don't have Wave. I'm that serious. If any requests come, I know my brother will handle all the requests. I'll just send the money to my brother. That's all I need to know. So if you are a couple of you guys, you need to stick to that, okay? You need to designate one person who hear the request, contest it over to the family. And also, the Kenyans are not badly off. They can chip in. Kama ni matanga. If it is a funeral, they can chip in to help out. And then the next thing is, seek a permanent solution to this problem. Yes, it's good to give now and then, but have you ever asked yourself, what if I'm not there in the picture? What happens? That's why you want to start thinking about the permanent solution. Okay? Even the request, if it is something that you cannot commit to 4 years of paying the school fee, please don't. But always seek permanent solution. Hey, if it is your old parent, can you buy them annuities in Kenya? These are savings account that can pay them for rest of their life. Or if you are good in business, you can build them plots. You can buy them cows, milk some milk. You can start them, I don't know, do chicken farming or I don't know, mboga farming. Whatever you can do, think of permanent solution. Because at the end of the day, you may not be there. Okay, and if they're really relying on you, start thinking permanent solution to this problem so that